So next up on the agenda, Marty.
Oh, yeah. Mark's going to give a little spiel on the RRCA.
By a show of hands, how many people in here are members of the RRCA? Good answer. You all are. As a member of the Main Track Club, of course, I'm a member of the RRCA. For those of you who don't know me, no, I shouldn't say that. Everybody probably knows me. I'm here tonight for a couple reasons. One, I just wanted to plug the RRCA, you know, and go over a couple things about, you know, who it is, what we do, and what it's all about. It's going to be real quick, so don't get excited. I've been on the board of directors now for 4 years as the Eastern Region Director. I mean, I've loved every second of this. This has been the greatest gig in the world. We go around the country for different board meetings. I was just in Houston a few weeks ago for the Olympic Trials. We had our board meeting on Friday, and we were fortunate enough to hang out with VIP passes and actually, you know, hanging out with Ryan Hall and, you know, Kara Gucher and Mev. It was an incredible experience to do that and be down there and part of that. I'm up for re-election, and our convention's coming up in March. Chandra's going down. I'm not sure if Brock's going down this year. But we have an annual convention. This year it's in Memphis. Next year it's in Albuquerque. Open to the public. Everyone's invited to come down if you're interested in race directing, club management. There's seminars on how to do this and how to do that. And a lot of great fun runs, too. And this floor is crazy sticky. You hear that? Yeah, I'm up for re-election and I'm working up for 2 more years. But I just wanted to go over tonight just a couple things about who it is, who we are, what we do, because the RRCA has just set some massive achievements. So part of this too, I'd like to introduce, if you don't know, Blaine Moore. Blaine, are you here? And back. You can stand up for 1 second. Blaine is going to be the state representative. Volunteer position. You know, he's now working with clubs, he's working with the Mount Desert Island people, Sub-5, Central Maine Striders. There's only a handful of clubs in Maine, but Brock is the go-between between the RRCA and those clubs. And that's what my job is as the Eastern Region Director. I work with the state reps in the states from Maine to West Virginia. And I work, you know, with those folks. And they network with the local clubs in their state, you know, on insurance services and programs, which I'll go over real quick in just a second here, just to give you a quick overview of what it is. And the state reps are really the backbone of the RRCA. But deviating from this for a second, I'm going to plug Blaine's book. Does everybody know Blaine has a book out?
Yes.
Does everybody know it's on Amazon.com?
Yes.
Does everybody know he has something tonight and you can buy one if you see Blaine later on?
Yay!
Blaine's too. Well, I was kind enough tonight to bring one. Is this microphone too loud? Is this annoying?
You're just talking too loud.
All right. Looks like this. Awesome. I looked at it in cooperation with the Ian Parlin. Yeah. Blaine's put this together. This is an awesome guy. I encourage everybody to take a look. Support Blaine as a club member, as our RRCA state rep, and as a fellow runner. He has been kind enough to donate this book tonight.
Yay.
So, who gets it? Yeah. The question is anybody's birthday today?
Ooh. I'll say yes.
You don't count, Junior. Okay, then the second question is, whose birthday is closest to today?
Mine's
a Howard? No. I know your birthday.
Well, who has?
Anybody have a birthday within 1 week of today? Seriously, Derek?
February 1st.
Do you have one of these books?
Yeah.
You do now. It's dedicated to grassroots running. Everyone says, what's the difference between the Red Runners Club of America and the USATF? Track and field. The RRCA clubs don't throw javelins, don't jump over hurdles, don't do the shot put. Grassroots distance running is what the RRCA is all about. And if you just look here, here's the shot of our board of directors. Brent Gare is our president, Dave Cotter out in Lake Tahoe, Dan Edwards at large, Mitch Garner is up in Ann Arbor, Michigan, he's our central region. Yours truly, put a hand for that one. Lena, she's down there in North Carolina. Dennis is our treasurer of Milwaukee's Wisconsin Striders of the Midwest. Bailey just joined us, an attorney from San Francisco, and Kelly is our at-large. And Jean Kanak down there, she's our executive director. It's a paid position. You know, we have a board of directors with a president, but we pay Jean, and she's really she's the meat of the organization. She's doing the work. So, on behalf of Jean and the RRCA board, at this moment, I'm taking a second to personally thank the Maine Track Club and Howard Spear and the Maine Marathon for the donations to the Roadrunners Club Kids Run the Nation Fund. This year, we already donated 1,000 from that race, and the Track Club donated 5-1. Well, you didn't make the 5 sign.
5 minutes.
Donated $2,000 from the club, and that went for $400-$500 grants to the Kids Run the Nation Fund. So that puts money right into the programs of these kids running organizations. And this is getting kids away from their Nintendos, away from their TVs, away from their, you know, iPods and things, and they're out there in the programs, they're running. They're being active and they're being healthier as you know, because of that. So thank you from the Roadrunners Club of America to the Maine Track Club, Howard from Maine Marathon. Thank you. Let's drive this thing here. Little tiny buttons. Sean, is this your thing?
Yes.
Sorry. That's okay. Quickly, the services of the RRCA. Look at this website. What do we do? I got it under control and I'd like to see. Thank you. We provide services for starting running clubs, how to start and manage an event, develop the guidelines for safe running. We get calls all the time. A club comes and calls us up and says, hey, I'm putting it 5 or 6 of us. We want to get together. We want to start a club. What do we do? Guess what? We have all the information right here. It's bylaw templates, guidelines. What's the other thing? Not just the bylaws. Charters, thank you very much. Exactly. And insurance, this is our biggest benefit that we offer running clubs. Their insurance rates are far superior to the USATF and all the events. Like the Borealis runs, you guys there this morning, you go out for your run. All of our events are insured and covered by the RRCA. So the Borealis run, the guy, the gang that goes out in the mid-coast, Brunswick, the Little Dog, any of our events, all RRCA covered insurance. And we do the club management and the conventions, the running awards. We also offer microfinance loans for a new club. Say you're a new club and you you want to buy a clock. You don't have any money. You haven't raised enough income and dues yet. We offer clubs almost interest-free loans to go out and make those purchases, and they can pay it back over time. It's going to be really beneficial. Some of the programs the RRCA has. The Championship Series, of which the Maine Marathon has been a championship state and regional event for many years. It's one of the highest, as we mentioned, as Jim was saying, in the strategic plans. This is an awesome event. It's extremely well done. It's nationally recognized as one of the best marathons in the country. You know, it's not your McMarathons like Rock and Roll Series and all those other ones out there that are just out for making an almighty buck. The Kids Run the Nation Fund is what I wanted to point out really quick. And I know, Chandra, I believe, time clock's ticking. $500 grants to these kids' programs. And this, as I mentioned, puts the money right into the hands of these kids. And some of the ones, you know, we're all fortunate in Maine here, but some of the inner city programs in New York, Chicago, some of these kids, they don't get 3 square meals a day like we get. You know, and the cutbacks, you know, the economy the way it is. Some of these kids, they join these after school running programs, and that might be the only meal they get that day. You know, it's kind of sad to hear that, but that's actually, you know, the case of what's going on. So the money is really beneficial because they're buying these kids healthy snacks and they're giving them, you know, meals in some cases. So that's really what I just wanted to mention quickly about that. We just had kind of a landmark in 2011. We went over 1,000 running clubs are part of the RRCA now and 200,000 members, which is quite an accomplishment, and it's a growing organization as well. I wanted to plug the Memphis Convention coming up. you know, since going in for re-election again, I've had a great time on my 4 years on the board, and I look forward to two more. And also, we're going to be launching an initiative. The RCA just has a program called the Runner Friendly Community. Have everybody heard of the Bicycle Friendly Community? You know, you see these placards as you roll into town sometimes, there's little signs. Well, chambers of commerce love that. You know, that's the kind of thing that draws people to that community to live and make arrangements. They have trails, they offer discounts for people organizing events, like on bike rides, things like that. The RCA came up with a program modeled after that for a runner-friendly community. Do you offer discounts or encourage, you know, athletic activities in the town? Do you have trails? You know, is your town council friendly, you know, towards runners and making events happen? So we're looking at a few communities in Maine. We're going to try and start with Brunswick because they have an awesome trail system up there, and they've expressed some interest in receiving that designation. Another thing that's gone real strong is the RCA coaching programs. Has everyone heard of this? Blaine, I know you've been to the coaching program. You're a certified coach, right? Yeah, this is an awesome program that, again, has taken off. We actually train people throughout the country. There's programs to how to be a coach and go out and lead these groups, and it's just been incredibly popular. And a new program that's coming out this year is the Race Director Certification Program. Talking to Chandra earlier, you know, in the mid-winter classic. A lot of times, and everybody in this room, Sandy, you know, Al, you know, Howard, can all kind of relate, you know, it's like, okay, I volunteered to help out with this race, and it's like, well, what do I do kind of thing? How does this work? There's been any formal training program how to be a race director, other than just kind of winging it and learning as you go. Well, starting soon, there's going to be an online program that you can go on and take this and receive a certification from the RRCA. It's going to be a great program. We've elicited some of the world's best event directors to put, you know, training modules that are all going to be online. Dave McGilvery from Boston, you know, for example, it's going to have a whole module on, you know, do's and don'ts, race direction, so we're looking forward to rolling it out really soon. And that is basically what I wanted to say about that. So thank you for putting up with that. The other thing I wanted to plug quickly was the Race the Runaways. One other thought on the marathons too. April 7th, as Brock mentioned, yeah, great success last year, despite that April 1st nor'easter that almost did us in. We actually had a meeting that afternoon on Friday as we were panicking because we couldn't get out set up the courts whether this was even going to happen, and we decided to hang in there, and had some amazing people came forward and did some plowing and stuff, and the race kicked off. So this year we were expecting to see well over 1,000 people. In fact, I just ordered 1,700 shirts, so they better be 1,700 people. So we look forward to people coming out on April 7th and doing that. We added the airport challenge this year, new event. The 1 mile race is at 9 o'clock, then the 13.1 half marathon is at 9:30. So jump in at 9, run the 1 mile, and jump in the next line for the half marathon and do 14.1, and got an awesome medal cooked up. If you want to see it, go check out Facebook or the event website. Featuring that, it's got a big P3 Orion, you know, which was the plane that used to fly out of there until a couple years ago. So check out the Race of the Runaways. And mixed marathons.
Hey.
What the? What?
Five was up a long time ago.
First of all, what would happen in Las Vegas at the Rock and Roll Marathon? Bob Orby and some people in that. It was a disaster. Who heard about the hot chocolate run down in Washington, D.C., where they took 20,000 runners and tried to put them onto an area that only had two roads coming into it? Another disaster. The RCA gets a lot of complaints. What do we do about these for-profit McMarathons who come to town? And there's one that's come to Freeport last year. I don't know if anybody remembers it. Don't go there. I'm going there. The message of the RCA, we're not going to, you know, impose sanctions or badmouth any of these races, so to speak. The message is support your hometown club race where the money goes to benefit local charities. Simple as that. Okay? And why are we aware? Thank you. Sometimes you want to pay $150, but that's it.